This program was first broadcast on Canterbury's community access radio station Plains FM 96.9 and was made with the assistance of New Zealand On Air.
It's time for Emergence News on Plains FM 96.9, citizen-made radio.
Welcome once more to Emergence News. In our previous program, Maitreya will be the world teacher for the next 2,500 years, the Aquarian Age. On today's program, we're going to look at the future work of Maitreya and the Masters. And I am joined by two regular contributors to Emergence News, Shafir.
Hello.
Hi, Shafir. And later on, you're going to be looking at Maitreya's mission.
Mm-hmm. Some of the future work that he'll be doing.
And Peter, you'll be looking today, very interesting topic, the role of the Buddha and also the structure of the hierarchy.
Indeed, I will, Nigel. Yep.
So we are going to continue with the fascinating subjects, namely Maitreya, the Masters of Wisdom and Avatars. And as we discussed on the previous program, the ageless wisdom teachings are as old as humanity itself. This is the teachings of a group of men and women who have gone beyond the strictly human stage and entered the next kingdom, the spiritual kingdom. They are the Masters of Wisdom and the Lords of Compassion. There are a number of these enlightened men and women on our planet, and they are the subjects of our discussion today. So, what is the relationship of the Masters to us? The answer is they are our elder brothers and sisters. They have gone ahead of us, and having finished the evolutionary journey on which we are still engaged, they have taken it upon themselves the responsibility of overseeing our evolution. And Shafir, you touched on this on the previous program. It's service.
Yes.
They know the way, they know the hazards, they know the possibilities. They know the steps which are best to take because there are many blind alleys and many pitfalls on the path. So they teach us the correct way. So let's take a look at the Masters and the structure behind the spiritual hierarchy in just a moment with Peter.
Right, well, it's quite interesting, really. The god, if you like, of our planet is called the Silent Watcher. And under his direct authority, I suppose you might say, is Senate Kamara, who is one of seven Kamaras that are actually involved in running the planet, as it were. They're the officials. And these three of those are on the esoteric level and four on the exoteric level. And so we have quite a complex issue there. And underneath them, there are three great beings. We have the Manu and the Bodhisattva, which is taken by the Christ. He actually has that office. And also the Mahakohen. And the Manu actually is involved deeply with the devas that are actually controlling the fires of the planet. And this includes earthquakes and volcanic eruptions and that sort of thing. And of course, it's been predicted that there will be more activity in that field at the moment. And we can see that. A lot of it we're saying is climate change and that sort of thing. But it is also part of the things that are and will be. So you might say that. So the instructions virtually for the Devic Kingdom come from the Manu and the Mahakohen. And they are controlled by great devic beings, you might call them archangels and that sort of thing. And they control the devas, which produce all forms in our dense physical body and also in our emotional body as well. And so they actually are responsible, you might say, for building of the form. So our bodies, our physical bodies, are actually made of devic substance. We are not the body. They are made by the devas for us. And we, the spiritual being, the solar angel, if you like, is we have the mind aspect to look after that body and to control it. But it is actually made of devic substance. And so it's a very complex thing altogether, but these the monads of will, if you like, the first initiation, the first ray types are controlled by the manu as well, and the bodhisattva, the Christ, actually controls the second ray individuals, the release of the love aspect of God, if you like, because everything actually on our planet is second ray as far as the consciousness is concerned, mm-hmm. but third ray as far as the physical is concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And so the Mahakohen actually looks after the third ray and the subsequent fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh ray. So the Mahakohen is here for the whole world period, you might say.
Mm.
So it's a long time that he's here, whereas the Manu and the Bodhisattva, the Christ, is actually here for a limited period. They are
for a designated period of time.
Yes, that's right. But because the Mahakohen has to look after those five rays, he's got a complex job. He's looking after all that ray energy that comes in. Each one of those rays has sort of got three aspects to it. So you can imagine there's a fair bit of work to do there. And so it is actually a very complex thing. I mean, in a way you can say God is love, and he can leave it at that level and he can say it's very simple. But in actual fact, if you go into the detail of it, it's quite complex. And so,
then underneath those three great beings, of course, then you've got the masters.
The masters, yes.
Of which Maitreya is the he is the head of the masters of wisdom.
That's right. Yes. Well, you have underneath that you've got the seven shohans of who are in charge of each ray, and then underneath those, each of those are another six sub units. So there's 49. Cosmic, groups that are part of our humanity, if you like.
Mm-hmm. Which are often called ashrams, aren't they?
Yeah, they are all called ashrams. Mm. And basically it's, they all have their, because they're in constant intuitional contact with each other, they don't stand on each other's toes at all because they're aware of exactly what the other one's doing. And so complete harmony, but they all have their own tasks, mm-hmm. and so they have the various things that they have to do, and develop that part of humanity, which is all in the mind of the silent watcher, who is our God.
Who's our God beyond our physical God.
That's
yes.
Right. Mm.
I've got a question here for you, Peter, and that is was put to Benjamin Krem, asking what is the role of the Buddha in our spiritual hierarchy, and also what is his relationship to Maitreya?
Yes, well, they both actually took the third initiation back in Atlantean times together, and the Buddha actually comes from the moon chain, which was an earlier system of our planet, and so they are brothers of old. These two, although, as I say, one's come from the earth humanity with the Christ, and the others come from the earlier moon chain.
But the Buddha, he no longer retains a physical vehicle.
No, that's right.
He dwells at Shambhala, doesn't he?
Yes, that's right. He actually is handing out the directions, if you like, of Sanat Kumara, who is the personality aspect of God.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's works in close conjunction with him. And at the Wesak festival, the Buddha actually comes in etheric form and is part of the a ceremony of the Wesak festival. And I don't know if you've heard of the Wesak festival, but it's a formation that's a festival that's held up in the Himalayas and in a valley there. It's on the dense physical plane and it's on the etheric plane as well. And so the Buddha comes in on the etheric level. And
so it makes the full moon of May a very powerful time.
It does. It is probably the most powerful one that we have, isn't it?
Yes, and I think it will be the major festival of the future time.
Yeah. Yes. So we have the three major festivals, the Easter festival, which is the Aries festival.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have the Taurus festival, which is the Wesak festival, and then the Gemini festival, which is the festival of the Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And
so since the Atlantean times, the Buddha and Maitreya have been at the forefront of humanity ever since. Maitreya, very much exoteric now. He's actually, here on the planet, whereas the Buddha remains very esoteric still.
That's right, yes. And so you see the close connection with Sanat Kumara.
Mm-hmm.
He's
like the intermediary, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Yes. Exactly.
In 1994, during an interview with Roland Olson in Los Angeles, Benjamin Krem said the plan of evolution is issued from the heavenly Lord, the Logos of this planet, the will of God, the plan of God issued from Shambhala. It is brought from Shambhala to the masters of our spiritual hierarchy by the Buddha. So there's another responsibility of the Buddha.
Mm-hmm.
The masters seek to carry out the plan through humanity. They give aspects of the plan to their various initiates and disciples. They are the men and women currently incarnated in the world to carry out so the transformations can take place. So that's given us a little bit of insight into
the management of the planet.
The management of the planet. Thank you, Peter. Excellent stuff. And in just a moment, Shafir joins us, and Shafir is going to talk about specifically Maitreya's mission over the next age. Welcome back to Emergence News. We're now going to hand over to Shafir, who's going to be talking about Maitreya's mission over the age of Aquarius. Shafir, what is the essence of his teaching for the new age?
Well, his teaching will be released in phases, and each phase being relevant to the needs of humanity at each stage over the next 2,350 years or so. And it's interesting to note that Maitreya was never born in a human body. He actually created a body of atomic energy that was dense enough for the Earth, but also had the was able to endure, because he will be here for the next 2,350 years, and that's a long time. And so this body needs to be able to withhold all the energy that he brings through, the love energy that is coming through him, and also
it's like a body of illusion, isn't it? That's what he calls it.
Is
actually a body of illusion.
Yes, because it can,
looks like a dense physical body.
It does, yes. But all the masters are able just to create bodies at will, just with their mind, and so that's he wasn't actually born as such. In the first place, we'll find that he will lay the emphasis on the oneness of humanity, on the fact that the human soul, on the need for sharing and right relationships. And we've talked about this many, many times, because this is the first step for humanity, isn't it? That we need to share the world's resources. And until we do that, until we make that step, I don't think he's going to be able to emerge fully into our lives. And I think we're beginning to start doing that, to see many, many on the grassroots level who are beginning to share, their produce, their ideas, and
A master on the previous program who is, his specific responsibility and his role is in empowering the labor movement around the world.
Yes.
And that's all to do with sharing resources.
Yes. Yes, definitely.
Not just individually, but also between the nations. That's the ultimate goal, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. So it's it is happening, and it is, as we said before, a gradual emergence of these ideas. Maitreya will teach again the law of cause and effect and its relationship to the law of rebirth. And showing the need for harmlessness in all relationships. And I think this is going to be absolutely huge, isn't it, for all of us to know that everything that we think, everything we say, and everything we do will have repercussions of some sort, you know.
That's right.
When you see so much of the hatred that's happening around the world, you know, if people realize actually this is going to come back to me, I think it's going to stop a lot of that. So,
and we do see instances of the speed of karma in action, don't we?
And it's getting faster, definitely, isn't it?
Definitely does.
No, it's happening. When these ideas have permeated society and brought about the changes in our political, economic, and social structures, he will set about the inauguration of a new world religion, bringing together the approaches of God of the East and West, God immanent and God transcendent, so God within and God without. He will teach the mysteries of the path of initiation, the scientific path to God. Initiation will be central to the new world religion. Above all, he will reveal a new aspect of God. This is the new revelation which he brings. And I think that, Benjamin Krems often told us that the majority of humanity is now standing on the door of the first initiation, which is the opening of the love aspect within each of us. And so that's going to be a huge sort of change to the world, and really one that's going to bring in this, what we call this golden age of humanity, or the golden age of Aquarius.
And this is one of the things that's creating the tension in the current age, isn't it? Is because there are so many of us ready to take the first initiation, numbers that has demanded that Maitreya has incarnated, well, not incarnated, but is on the planet because of the huge responsibility he has as the Hierophant.
Yes. That's right. Yes, he takes the first two initiations, and, so he needs to be there. But there's, as you say, millions already on the borderline.
Right on the cusp of the first initiation.
Yes. Mm.
Which is very exciting, isn't it? Because it's going
fantastic.
To transform the world. But just, going on that he's the Hierophant of the first and second initiation, what's happened is that, when he says nobody gets to God except through me, that's been taken by the Christian church as being he's the only one who can do it. And he is, but he's not here as a Christian leader, is
it's
he?
Not, no, it's not,
he's not, here
not
as,
to do with Christianity.
It's not to do with Christianity. it's to do with the idea of initiation.
And the idea of a new religion, which you were mentioning there too, it's a big task, isn't it? Because if you think about in the West, Our approach, our philosophy regarding religion is often very academic, and it's, we like to discuss it. Whereas in the East, it's a very practical. They use specific practices so that you can experience consciousness
and
being raised
and having a direct relationship with divine divinity. Whereas in the Western world, it's more you have to go through the priest, or you have to go through, they don't really encourage the direct sort of relationship. It's really interesting with Christianity, when people claim that they saw miracles, they're often said that they didn't, and they were making it up or whatever, because they didn't like this idea that you could have a miss out the middle man sort of thing.
So I don't envy the Master Jesus's task of transforming the Christian churches. There's a lot of work ahead.
There is a lot of work ahead. Yes. Yes.
And of course, some of the other aspects of Maitreya's mission is on the subject of death. We need to lose the fear of death, don't we?
Exactly.
We do. Yes.
We're spiritual beings. We're not dense physical beings only.
And what Benjamin Krem says is that we will one day really look forward to it. We'll be planning for it. We'll make a big party around it, and we'll all be ready to go, sort of knowing that the body now no longer serves us. I suppose it's just like, your old car, might have a bit of a sentimental attachment to it, but actually
it's time to move on.
Yes. Time to get a new one.
And it's always a lovely experience moving on.
Yes. Yes, it can be.
And very freeing.
But we've made such a lot of fear around death, and it really does affect the way that we live our lives.
Yes.
So apart from death, there'll be new approaches to discovering the causes of diseases, and alternative medicines will take their place besides the more orthodox methods. Doctors and healers will begin to work collaboratively. Now, I heard a lovely story the other day about how chiropractors sometimes work in the ED, And if somebody goes in with a heart attack, just by doing a body, or what they think might be a heart attack, just by doing a body alignment, can actually release the congestion, you know. And I think this is what's going to be happening a lot, where we'll see a lot of these alternative practitioners going in and working with the what they call them, allopathic doctors. And that'll be.
It's exciting, isn't
it? It is exciting, yes. Mm-hmm. And to think that it's actually really happening now.
And also education.
Education, yes.
That's a big area, and it's really important as we move forward. Maitreya says that our teachers, there needs to be the ability for our teachers to understand the child better. And you can see the birth of this already. You know, the children with special needs, learning difficulties are being much more catered for. And the point of evolution, that's going to become a key component of the teacher's arsenal to understand what is where that child is at,
that's right.
Why they've incarnated at this time, where that what point of evolution they're at,
and their race structure as well.
Yes,
their race structure, and there will be the mystery schools, and all around the world there'll be. Creating these mystery schools for people to go and study the art of initiation. And so we'll be going through those initiations, and we'll be striving for that. That's what we'll be going. It would be like our universities, you know, to learn the art of initiation, and which is apparently a forcing process for us to evolve.
Yes, a hothouse.
A hothouse, yes.
Arrangement, yes.
The earth feels like a hothouse at the moment.
It does. Yes. Definitely. So it's going to be a really exciting time. And, you know, apparently Maitreya will be going around the world with some of the masters and into each country and, you know, helping whatever needs to be done in each country. And I suppose it'd be like the Pope does now, you know, going around, and we'll be able to see him in an actual physical body and hear him. And one of the other stories I heard is that, we will see him on television, and that will be a real sort of a wonderful experience for us, where he can actually give out, he gives out the blessings through his messages now, and gives out the blessings to the whole world. And, so it's going to be really a different world that we're going to be living in. Mm.
This is the Emergence News on Plains FM. For more information, go to shareinternational.org. And this little excerpt from Share International about Gautama. Gautama foresaw Maitreya. Now in those days, brethren, there shall arise in the world an exalted one by name Maitreya, the kindly one, an arhat, a fully enlightened one, endowed with wisdom and righteousness, a happy one, a world knower, the peerless charioteer of men to be tamed, a teacher of the devas and mankind, an exalted one, a Buddha like myself. He of his own abnormal powers shall realize and make known the world, and the worlds of the devas, with their maras, their brahmas, the host of recluses and brahmins, of devas and mankind alike, even as I do now. He shall proclaim the norm, lovely in its beginning, lovely in its middle, and lovely in the end thereof. He shall make known the whole perfect life of righteousness in all its purity, both in the spirit and in the letter of it, even as I do now. He shall lead an order of brethren numbering many thousands, even as I do now lead an order of Brahman numbering many hundreds.
All this information can be found on the Share International website, www.share-international.org. Scorpio Books in Christchurch carries the magazine and some books. And also don't forget the podcasts, which are available on the Plains FM website.
We welcome your comments, questions and feedback. Please contact us at emergencenews@gmail.com.
The opportunity to join our transmission is available Monday and Wednesday evenings and Thursday mornings, which gives us the possibility to do a service meditation in conjunction with Masters.